participating in all sorts of decor tricks.
Tricks.
Jackie Morra here, interior designer. How are you?
I'm good. Yourself?
Good.
Good morning.
So excited to get started because this is a color scheme that we're trying to achieve in my house right now, so I can't wait to see how you put it all together. We begin with a rug.
Yes.
How big do we go? What colors do we go? How bold?
Well, the thing is to start with a piece that you absolutely love, and you can use the rug as an inspiration, or you can use a picture or piece of artwork. And most of the work's already done for you. So if you take a look at the color schemes in the rug or in the picture, we've got the blues, the creams, and the chocolates. So those are already your pieces to look for in terms of color and inspiration. So if you want to build on the rug or build on the photos, then you start to look at the patterns, and do you want more contemporary, what we were talking about?
You play with the patterns on patterns.
Yes, absolutely. With fabrics, what you want to look at is that make sure there's a floral, mm-hmm. then you can team it up with a stripe, or you can team it up with a solid. And you want to think about if the rug is a large print like this one in particular, you can go with a medium or a small stripe. You want to play the opposite of it.
Gotcha.
And you can also add in pieces that are neutral.
And Jackie, I noticed you went dark with the rug, so you went lighter with this, rich with this, so then would the couch be more of a solid, lighter color?
Absolutely. Okay. And I've got some fabrics that I can show you, because also if it's a bigger piece of furniture, you want it to have some longevity, and if you get sick of the blue, for example, you can change it out and accessorize, which is the whole point of this.
It's like magic. If only we're always so easy. Thanks, guys. This is something we gave away on the show at Leon's
you
last
were mentioning.
Week. That's funny.
Yeah, it's a fabulous chair.
So let's go this way, because you brought a whole bunch of accessories, which is key.
So basically, now you want to have the finishing, you want to add the finishing touches, and I was talking about the patterns. So the rug is basically a floral. You need your rug to be at least 6 inches under the furniture. It should always be on all pieces of furniture because it just doesn't look right. It looks like it's a little bit too skimpy.
Okay.
Also, the space doesn't look very filled and it doesn't look coordinated. So the rug is going to be your inspiration. Then the fabrics we've got here, this is a floral, this is a stripe, and then we've put a small geometric print. So again, we're talking with a large scale pattern, a medium stripe, and then a small geometric. And you want to mix those three pieces together.
All in the subtleties. They flatter each other, but they're still contrasting.
Absolutely. Then we're not finished. Lighting is a big part of accessorizing as well, too, because whatever colors you like, lighting affects the color, and it really helps to, you know, create the mood in the space. And that's what decorating and accessorizing and color is all about.
Yeah.
What mood do you want to create? Do you want it to be warm and inviting? Do you want it to be contemporary? Do you want it to be soft? Do you want it to be bold and bright? But the accessories really help to finish the pieces.
And that's the thing too, Jackie, with something like this with your color scheme. I love that you're playing on different shapes, sizes, and there's kind of a traditional and modern theme fused together, so it's timeless.
Absolutely. And when you're looking at displaying accessories, don't be afraid to use different materials. We've got a sort of an elegant crystal piece for the candle. Then we've got some simple pottery, and you can fill it with whatever you want. You could put in a piece of a plant or something from nature. But think about it in terms of heights, different heights and levels. You want to create everything. You want to create a little scene for each piece.
Okay.
And so when you're looking at it, you visually get to appreciate each piece, and they're also working together, and they're being picked up through color.
Come over here, love. Let's take a look at some of the rods.
So now
I don't bite, I swear.
No, you're absolutely wonderful.
I promise you, I showered this morning.
So did I. Very early. So this, the scene we were talking about, it's a little bit more modern with the different shapes and the more contemporaneous of the fabrics. You can also do a little bit more traditional.
Beautiful.
And so I've changed the shape of the lamp to make it a little bit more traditional.
So you don't need matchy-matchy. Can you have that lamp with this lamp in the
same room?
Absolutely. I like it.
Absolutely. As long as you see the bases are both brushed nickel and the shades are the similar taupe. So as long as there's, in terms of height and scale and balance, as long as they're working together. But then, you know, you didn't have to go with a modern rug. You could have gone something a little bit more traditional, and we could have brought in a floral. If you're a sofa, for example, the larger piece, which is a bigger investment, which you probably want a little bit more neutral, you can do a neutral color, but it actually can be more texture. It doesn't have to be boring.
Great job, Jackie.
And
I'm so sorry. We've run out of time, but there's so many beautiful things. I mean, really well put together, and I think we had a lot of great tips today. Thank you so much.
Thanks.
Seminars are taking place this weekend?
No, they're actually coming up October 17th and 18th. And the 24th and the 25th. It's a decorating workshops where you're going to learn all sorts of tips and tricks.
Awesome.
And it's to raise money for Canadian Women's Foundation for Girls Inc. So you can check out the website.
Thank you for taking part. Lots of great tips. HomeDecorSolutions.ca for more information on this and more with Jackie.
Thanks, you for
Jackie.
Having
you
me.
You were great.
Thanks.
Over to Kevin in the newsroom.